Hello friends, welcome to part two. If you watched yesterday's video, we are smack dab in the middle of our day. And yesterday's video for you guys is still our day today, but we are doing two parts because it has been an eventful day. To catch you up really quick, we did a lot in the garage today. I've run an errand, gotten Ashley's friend a birthday present, which we are going to take with us. We also are trying to sell our Oculus. If you are local in Washington and want to buy an Oculus, we're selling it for $200. We are getting Ashley's birthday bag ready to go. She not only has cozy slippers to wear there, but these are house slippers. And she knows that they have a no-shoe policy inside their house, so she's taking those. She's also taking her weighted dinosaur and her cheer sweatshirt. Jason, can you put this into her backpack here for us to put into the car? I have to pack a clear bag for clear bag policy for, what is that? Did it say what that stadium is called, Jace?
Husky Stadium.
Husky Stadium.
Well, it's next to it. They probably technically have
it. It is. It's a different arena.
It's the same directions. Come on.
Okay. I know. I got to go do her hair. Ashley, stop. Seriously, child, I'm coming. You're in your uniform, you got your makeup on.
And I need concealer.
I told you where their concealer was.
Yeah, I know, but I'm gonna like, if I need to retouch it.
Oh, then go get it real quick. Okay, but I am trying to make sure I have everything out of my purse that I might need. Not much, I just need a card. I don't need that. We'll do some sanitizer, AirPods. Chapstick, just put that into here. She doesn't really need like food to eat. I don't know, maybe I don't need, we'll see. Then I need to do her hair. And, let me just.
We're doing her hair, so we're not going to the car right now?
No, we're not going to the car. We're keeping an eye on the map on traffic to see.
About 40 minutes.
Yeah, the drive is 40 minutes. We're gonna leave an extra 20 minutes. We have 15 minutes until that start time. We always kind of back into, this is how you get places on time. You back into the time you need to be there. Okay, so I need to, can we spray it a little bit wet? And then do you want to put gel on it before I do it?
Gel when I'm done.
Okay, gel is up in Dad's bathroom. Do you want me to send him to get it?
Run it down.
Oh, you did? Okay. I will give you an update in the car. I'm gonna have him drive.
You have to go?
I have a little bit of information about Abby. She's at work tonight. Do not have to take her to the hospital today, but I'll fill you in when we are gonna take her. All right, we made it out perfectly on time. I think we still have our 20 minute leeway for traffic if it suddenly like backs up.
Whoa, it did get snow.
Yeah, oh yeah. She's gonna go check for her palms. I was gonna show you the snowy topped mountain, but we can't see it anymore. Is it back there?
No.
No, it's down underneath.
I have them.
You have your palms?
Yep.
You don't want your bag, you just need the palms.
I can't.
Right, you can't have bags. I need cold air on me, like ASAP here. But anyway, okay, so we are headed over. We have plenty of time, and Jason's driving. So I don't think we need to take the toll bridge. I think we just take 90 and go across. All right, so Abby, I have a nurse who understands I need an appointment on an emergency basis. Couldn't obviously get her in today. We might have been able to had they actually done their due diligence to look at the calendar and see if they could have gotten us in, but they're gonna get her in next week, and they do see it as an emergency. I was able to talk to my dad and kind of explain the situation to him. Not that I don't ask him for questions, and I'm only gonna listen to him as a doctor. I use him as a second opinion, if you will, or just more information than I get from the doctor. Hang on. All right, never mind. I thought we had to answer that call, but we don't. So I talked to my dad, which I'll tell you something interesting about my dad. and the reason why he called. But I was talking to him about everything that's going on, and he was like, yes on the antibiotic, yes on getting in for an emergency appointment. The antibiotic is the number one thing. And he said the likelihood of that pin or whatever contraption is in there, the pin system that is in her cheek, jaw area that is now sore, swollen, possibly likely infected, that pin, we're just gonna call it that, there's probably multiple pins in there, has likely been rejected by the body and or has an infection from somewhere else that has traveled to the site and has become infected. She did have a sinus infection a couple weeks ago. It was very short-lived, it didn't last any, we didn't even need medication, but my dad said that little bit of an infection could have traveled and took up residency in the pin, and then the pin doesn't like being in there. So he said, obviously your doctor is gonna go in and look at it, they might do an x-ray, they might just do an exam, you know, he'll do his what he needs to do, but there's a good chance they will need to remove the pin if the bone is really fully done growing back into place, which is likely because they wouldn't let her chew if that wasn't the case. And so, but that can be done in office with local anesthesia, and just they'll go and do a little surgical incision and take the pins out, whatever is in there. He said that's likely what will happen. So I just appreciate when he kind of gives me a heads up about things like this and kind of gives me details and lets me answer, you know, ask questions and whatnot. So then when I talk to the doctor, it's not so much of a surprise. I can ask him more follow-up questions. Like my dad will tell me, ask him this, ask him this. So it's really helpful to talk to my dad and kind of reassure me that yes, there's something wrong. And your doctor is correct. If we have a fever, if we have discharge, if it swells up anymore, if there's redness, go straight to the ER. And that's what my surgeon said as well. And don't even waste the time going over to Children's Hospital ER. Go straight to our ER, and they will contact the surgeon and his team, and they will work together over the phone on what to do for Abby. So we have all these backup plans. Hopefully we can get her scheduled for an appointment early next week and get her in. So that's the update on that. Anything else happened today? That still haven't gotten an answer on her car. I didn't expect to get that answer today, but as I told Carlos, if you remember our whole saga with the car, I told Carlos I'm in for the long haul. I don't need to get this fixed anytime soon. I've got money from them sitting in my bank. The car works just fine. I want it fixed. I don't need to have it fixed right away. I can sit and wait on them all we want. And for insurance, they have an open claim. And they want it closed. And they want me done with. So I can do the long haul all we want until you want to make a decision to fix the one little teeny tiny part and move on from me. So we'll find out about that later on. It's nice that it's not raining. Driving over there, that always like makes traffic even worse. I wish we were just a bit later in the night to get an actual sunset, but I don't think we're gonna get that. He's very focused on the driving
because it's traffic.
I know, but you have resting bee face, man.
I do too.
No, you don't. You have a happy face. You look cute though.
Man, driving in traffic face.
No, you don't. You have whatever. You tossed me like a stone. You swept me off my feet. I can't feel my bones. I still count the days. You swept me off my feet. I keep going high, she keeps going low. Something feels wrong right now, I know. Something feels wrong. You don't wake me, 'cause I keep breathing fire. I won't wait for you, 'cause you keep telling lies. We are starting to get to know our way around these campuses and whatnot. We're over here at UW, but Ashley and I are starting to recognize this is the parking lot we go to. This is the entrance we go to. Second season, Next season might be looking a little bit different. I don't know. Seems like we might be getting kicked out of the rec team. Board of director drama going on with her squad. But for now, we still have a squad and we're still performing and we're having fun. And Jason's trying to find a spot that has no one parked next to him. Or to find another Tesla.
Oh, it's right there. There's one right there.
What? Where? Oh, we're off in here?
Nope. Keep going.
She knows what to look for. There's a bunch of Teslas up here.
Well, there's this spot
here. There's a Tesla right next to you. Keep going.
Well, there's here.
So, Turn left.
Turn left?
Yeah. Or just park in the end ones up here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
You park like there so that no one can ding you. Just make sure you don't. Oh, okay.
What?
Okay, it's a little cold, so we've got out her cheer jacket and a pair of pants. I know, it's the right colors. Luckily, she had pajamas packed for her sleepover, and we had a regular cheer bag, but we can't take her cheer bag in, so we have to carry Pom's, and then I have to take all of her clothes as soon as we get in. But we're early, so we're gonna have to stand outside and wait. So we just wanted to get her. Do you want the other jacket to keep warm or no? I keep going high, she keep going low. At the end of the day, she's gone low. You don't wait for me, cause I keep breathing fire.
Should have seen it come. You acted numb, don't deny.
So we're all done, and Ashley flew for the first time in a performance.
Yeah.
Right, Ashley, come behind me. Tell me what you thought.
Good.
You did slip,
but got
a little
back
bit,
up.
Right?
I got back up.
And then just tell me what you were just saying about someone that was right in the front row watching you guys.
They started crying.
Why?
And I'm like, and they were just a college student, and I didn't think they had, I was like, oh, they may be a parent, but I'm like, no, they're like a college student, and then they started crying.
Because they thought it was so good?
Yeah. Because like hip hop, they started crying during hip hop, and then they started crying during.
You're alone? Yeah.
Yeah.
So she's on a couple different squads now. She's on the competitive squad that does the whole flying routine. She's now a flyer for what, two more performances?
Nope. Next year I'm flying too.
No, I know, but like this year you're two more performances and then Japan. But then she's also on a dance drill team that then they did the first dance was hip hop.
Hip hop, but
and I have never seen that dance before. Yeah. You haven't performed that one yet?
Very sassy.
Very sassy.
Very sassy.
Very.
Yeah.
Yes, we have to be sassy.
Yeah, no, you,
it, well, you nailed it.
You gotta have flair.
That's one characteristic you have, my friend.
Yeah.
It comes in handy. So, very good.
Say I need enough.
I can't say that about the UW women's basketball team. Although, as we were leaving, they were finally ahead in the score. So, I think he would have enjoyed staying for the game. But we have to get this one to her party. And it's cute because the birthday girl's mom texted me. And she's like, about maybe like a half hour ago. And she's like, all the girls want to know when Ashley's coming. And I was like, we have one more quarter. So I'm going to, as soon as we get to the car, I'm going to send him.
No, I want to call them.
No, I know, but we should send him one of the videos. Or two of them.
Power. I'm not sending him that.
You don't want to send him the flyer one? Or dance drill.
I'm power. I am dance drill. I don't want to
dance
send
drill?
Up whatever that's called.
You don't. Come on.
Diamonds.
All right. Well.
That one's just more.
I'm gonna send it to
you
him.
You only have one thing.
Because they don't. Some of them don't know that she's the flyer.
Yeah.
So
diamonds wasn't the one.
Anyway, I am glad that we leave at halftime, so we can avoid the traffic going home. It is so cold out here.
It's so hard to breathe after. Like I breathe during it. But then it's just like my
well, throat, you've like, been doing just, a whole workout.
It's just like
closes up.
Yeah.
Ooh, ooh.
Someone
you're out there. Dude, it was so cold to be out here playing soccer.
Oh. Hip hop. Our coach who started Autumn. She is our choreographer, and she started crying because she made the whole dance.
Oh, she did the whole thing.
Hip hop, and she started crying.
Aww.
Because she saw us doing it for the first time.
There's a lot of tears today, so it's like.
Yeah. Well, no, that performance was really good. Like I said, the moms behind us, maybe I didn't tell you guys, the moms behind us had like kids in the first, you know, in the big
intro.
Group, intro group. And so they didn't know that there were flyers and dance drill teams and different performances. And so they were behind us, whoa, oh my gosh, I can't believe it. Oh my gosh, they threw her. And so, it was kind of fun, and they were like, is this your kid? I'm like, yep, that's my kid right there. So that was a little proud mama moment for me. All right, just dropped Ashley off at her party. I don't know if she's gonna sleep over or not. Just talked to the mom, my friend. I'm like, just told her to be honest with herself. If she's tired, she's had a full day of school and dance tonight. So she needs to be okay to either go to sleep if the girls aren't, or call me and I'll come get her and bring her home. So she said only three extra girls are ending up sleeping over as well, because the other ones have like soccer in the morning or you know whatnot. So let's see. Oh, she might have. Oh, that is so cute. So my friend, the mom of the birthday girl, she said, oh my goodness, I wish he would have stayed for the scream when they saw her. Oh. My ears are bleeding. Aww. Anyway, sorry, it went blurry there. I don't know how much of that was blurry. But it's cute that we were just talking that these kids have been so excited for Ashley to get here. The party started like 2-3 hours ago, and we knew she was going to be late. And they have been texting me all night. When is Ashley come? When is she coming? When is she coming? And like, is she almost on her way? And It's like they're waiting, they're acting like she is the birthday girl showing up late to her own party, but the birthday girl is already there.
They're all such
They're just all really good friends, and they're really good at supporting each other and being excited for each other, and like they're all, like Ashley told me, she's like, don't send them very many photos or videos because they want to watch them with me. So it's kind of cute that she has such good friends and they have such a good support system. I want Ashley to start going to some of their games. The only problem is that their games and their practices are on the exact same nights as Ashley's. So it's hard for her to like go and offer her support to them at the same time. So I don't know. Are we going home? Are we going to bed?
Oh,
it's not even 9. I'm hungry because all we've had was a stupid pretzel.
I'll make you something at home.
I don't feel hungry enough to go and sit down and eat something. It's almost 9 o'clock, but we didn't technically eat dinner.
We can't just go get like an ice cream because then
that's all.
Feels bad.
Doesn't sound like a bad idea. But we haven't had dinner. What do we do?
Well, I've got to turn what direction.
We're living on the edge, going for a little DQ, right? We're just gonna get a milkshake, see if the girls want one too. All right, good old chocolate with Reese's in it, and I got Chelsea an Oreo Blizzard, and you got?
Cookie dough.
Cookie dough, and Abby said she didn't want any. I think her mouth really hurts her. She doesn't like turn down ice cream very often.
Mm-hmm.
So she must not be feeling so good.
Oh, girl.
Or she's just ready for bed. She probably just got home from work, I don't know, maybe an hour ago. So I feel kind of bad. Do you want to sit in? We can eat it.
Yeah, let's just sit and chat.
Pretend like, oh no, we are on a date. I'm just kidding. We didn't have like a meal. Like we didn't go out to dinner or anything. This is, we're doing our sacred loneliness together.
Yeah, no, I was like, I will do my best to pretend that I'm enjoying the date with you.
No, what did he say?
What did he say though?
No, he said
differently.
He said it was easy to pretend.
Is that what he said?
It was, no, but not, is it, it was easy.
It wasn't
not,
pretend.
It was a play. It was easy to.
Oh gosh, it's ridiculous.
The act was easy. And she said, yeah, but you didn't act very well. And he's like, what? You knew all along? Who knows what we're talking about? All right, date night is over. The rest of our night is over.
Date time is over.
No, I said date night is over. And Ashley's at a party. Let's see, Chelsea's. She's gotta be asleep because we texted both her and Abby if they wanted a milkshake. Abby said no, and Chelsea still hasn't responded to us. So I'm assuming she's asleep. We sat in the car and watched, what was it called? Not the Queen.
The Crown.
The Crown. About the Queen. Which was kind of fun. So we're just gonna close up shop down here. It's weird to like actually have the kids in bed. Ashley's our night owl.
It's cold, so I'll leave that
on.
Yeah,
it's 35, 37 degrees outside. It's really cold. It's like out of the blue.
Maybe we get snow.
Maybe you'll actually be able to go skiing.
I know.
So we're gonna go to bed. Take care, you guys. I don't wanna talk going up there. I don't wanna leave the camera down here. I'm pretty sure Chelsea's asleep, so.
Yeah.
Thank you. That was a fun day.
Yeah.
Got a lot done.
Sure.
What's wrong?
Sure.
I don't know if I got that on camera. All right. Take care, you guys. Thank you for listening to or watching part 2 of our very long day. And I hope you have a good week. I don't know at what point you're going to watch this. Maybe you're going into a weekend. So I hope you have a good weekend. And we'll talk to you guys next time. Good night.